So now we're going to look at another super fancy example of these crazy, ridiculous combinations of transformations of functions. And now we're going to look at an actual function. So we've been looking at shapes before, mostly because I think they're easier to see what's going on. But probably on your homework, you're not going to have pretty shapes. You're going to have annoying lines and other various functions. So this is probably closest to one of the ugliest problems you might have on a homework assignment. So what we're going to do is we're going to analyze the function that we're looking at and make sure we know exactly what's going on. We always start on the inside of the function and look at the shift. So on the inside of the parentheses, we have that plus 2. Anything on the inside goes left to right. Remember, everything on the inside is backwards from what you think it should be. So that means the plus 2 must go to the left. And it does. All right. Then the next thing we're going to look at is that 3. And 3 is on the inside, so it's left to right. It's also on the inside, so it means it's backwards from what you think it should be. So the 3 means we're going to smush it by 1/3. Then we're going to have a left-right flip. Then we make our way outside to that other 3. So that's going to be a stretch of 3, an up-down flip, and then the 1 on the end is going to take us up 1 unit. So let's see how this is going to work. Start with the shifting to the left of 2. Doop-de-doop-de-doo. All right, so there's our shift left of 2. Now we're going to look at our smush of a third. So anything that's not on the y-axis is going to be smushed toward the y-axis. Now I promise this is where you're going to mess something up. You're not going to smush the right direction. I always want to smush up and down first because I just like it because it's fun. You have to remember that when you're inside the parentheses, you're smushing toward the center. You're smushing toward the up-down center. So anything that's on the up-down is going to stay where it is, and that's one of the reasons I like to kind of mark it. I promise you, when I do these on pencil and paper, with pencil and paper, I do not use just one graph. I use 4 or 5 different charts and follow each step as I go. Okay, so anything that's not on the y-axis is going to smoosh toward it. So you can see if I apply a factor of 1/3 to where the distance from all of them to the y-axis, that's where they're going to end up. Yep, just like that. Okay. So the next thing that I'm going to look at now is my left-right flip. And there she goes. It's my left-right flip. Isn't she pretty? Now I'm going to look at my up-down stretch. Stretch by a factor of 3. So anything that's already on the center line is going to stay where it is. Everything that's not on the center line is going to find itself pulled out. 1, 2, 3. Just like that. Okay. Now I'm going to do my up-down flip. Down flip, and then finally I'm gonna move up 1 like that. So what you've got now is the original in blue and our final transformation in pink, and these are extraordinarily frustrating to try to do on paper, and they look really funny with lines, which is, again, if you're feeling like you kind of understood it until this one, or maybe didn't understand it at all, but if you at least understood it until this one, that's completely understandable. That's because we're a lot more comfortable looking at simple shapes like triangles and squares, whereas when we start having arbitrary lines drawn on a piece of graph paper, it's a lot harder to see what's going on. So let's look at the total animation of this again. All right, so we're going to start going left, then we're going to do a smush toward the center, going up and down, smush. And then we're going to do our left-right flip. Flip. I just want you to be convinced that what we're doing actually was legitimate. I didn't just pull the wool over your eyes, because you can see it all at once now. And I'm going to do an up-down flip. Flip. And I'm going to shift up 1. And there she goes. So you can see where we started originally and where we ended up. And for me, one of the things that was really important for me to do is to make myself sit here and stare at it until I could visualize how I got from that stupid blue line to that stupid pink line. And once I figured that out, things started to come together a little bit better. But I can guarantee you that depending on the kind of visual person you are, I'm not a very visual person, so it takes me absolutely forever to see what's going on, and I'm always having to remind myself about what's going on. So if it's taking you forever, don't feel bad.